Inilunsad kamakailan ang Portraits of Success, isang coffee table book compilation ng mga artwork ng Filipino-Australian artist na si Ramon Coloma. Ginawa ang book launch ng dalawang gabi sa Penshurst RSL at sa St. Joaquim Community Hall sa Lidcom na dinaluhan ng mga art enthusiasts. Nasa Portraits of Success ang mga paboritong likha ni Coloma na unang pinakita sa publiko sa isang art show noong nakaraang taon.
This book is very important to me because my objective is to reach as many people as I can.
Ito ang mga ginuhit niyang portraits ng mga tanyag na tao na may malalaking kontribusyon sa iba't ibang larangan.
Like Pope Francis and several other prominent people and ordinary people, including my wife Annie.
Sa book launch, isinagawa din ang auction ng ilang mga paintings ni Coloma para sa charity.
Doing exhibitions is limited and through the book, even I'm not personally present, I'm able to express my message.
Ito ang kwentong AK427, your click to Pinoy's Down Under.
We have associated holiness with being drab, being uncheerful, being severe. So you see, very few priests, bishops, and sisters smile.
Maraming Pinoy ang nasiyahan sa pagbisita dito sa Australia ni Cardinal Luis Antonio Tagle kamakailan. Buong puso ang pagtanggap ng marami sa binansagang Smiling Cardinal. Bumisita si Cardinal Tagle ng ilang araw sa Sydney at Melbourne para sa ilang speaking engagements. Hinirang na Arsobispo ng Maynila noong 2011 at naging Cardinal noong 2012. Si Cardinal Tagle ay miyembro ng Pontifical Councils for Family, for Migrants, and for the Laity. Sa Sydney, nagmisa siya sa Our Lady of Fatima Parish sa Kings Grove at sa Parramatta Marist School. At nakipag-ugnayan din siya sa Filipino-Australian community. Nagsalita ukol sa iba't ibang mga issue si Cardinal Tagle.
The church has not changed its position, you know, and the church in the Philippines does not have any right to change the universal teaching of the church. So it will abide by the teaching. In terms of pastoral care for family, that's the calling to the church in the Philippines, and especially in the area of helping parents become responsible, and also making the whole community work towards the alleviation of poverty. It is customary for some sectors to say that families are poor because they have many children. Even a single person without any spouse or children can be poor. I know so many single people who are poor and they have no children to blame for their poverty. We have to look at the other roots of poverty. And right now in the Philippines, with the scandal about corruption, then you can't blame children. You blame adults who have failed in their promises to uplift human being and human lives. Now why don't they look at that too? There's much to do than blame children. In the area of corruption, even from my youth, you know, the church has always declared, of course, you know, its disgust at actions and systems of corruption. And in the recent revelations, the church has been promoting transparency in the investigations and also restitution for this obligation to return whatever has been taken away unlawfully and just unjustly from especially the poor. In January, even without the World Youth Day, Pope Francis will be visiting the Philippines, and I have been hearing people talking about breaking the record.
Pero higit sa lahat, isa ang paalala ng Smiling Cardinal sa mga Pilipino, ang maging tapat sa pananampalataya.
Holiness is a grace that should be lived in our day-to-day concerns and day-to-day life. If you're a teacher, you're called to be holy that right there in the school. Live according to the will of God. No, if you're a businessman, then try to be holy as in the world of business. Do not do anything that will go against the commandments of the Lord. No, if you're a cab driver, then be holy. You know, as a cab driver, learn how to look for after the safety of the people that you're dealing with. So holiness is livable, you know, in all the demands of life, and in this case, in the daily life of family.
Ito ang kwentong AK427, your click to Pinoy's Down Under.